in the last hour of day, the shadows climb up the wall. These three towers here find their shadows cast across the great courtyard onto the walls of the Pavilion Sully, the Sully Pavilion. And this shadow in particular catches my eye as it crawls up the wall toward the sky. When the shadows finally reach the top, they will all be caught up in the greater shadow of the earth itself. As the sun appears to go down behind the horizon, and we turn forward into night. Tuesday. The Louvre is closed on Tuesday. On any other day, there would be floods of people coming out at closing hour. But today, there are just a few passing back and forth, haunting the plaza. The gallery has been quiet all day long. If I remember rightly, I believe that one of the first videos I shot was inside the Denon Pavilion, this central tower here, and I was on upper floor here, in a great two-story room that stretched up and up overhead, climaxing in a wonderful ceiling. Somewhere up there, as I sit here 2 weeks later, well, tomorrow it'll be 2 weeks, I think to myself, wow, it feels almost like a year since I sat inside those windows and made one of my first vlogs from the Louvre. You can see what time it is by the clock on the tower of the palace. Bow down before the camera, oh ye mighty tourists. interesting to watch the sun go down on the palace, all the traffic roaring through, the crows of Paris looking for their dinner. I swear they know I have a sandwich in my pocket. Birds have been giving me the eye all day long. You've got something in your pocket. You've got something in your pocket, and we want some of it. Yeah. The gardens actually start right here behind me. There's sort of a maze kind of thing in there behind hedges. You can go in and there's a secret hidden garden inside. When I first sat down here about 15 minutes ago, I heard children screaming with laughter in there behind those hedges. Yes, it was delightful. Children screaming with laughter. Look, the lampposts are casting their shadows on the walls of the tunnel archways. There are six tunnels that go through there, if I'm counting right. People are coming out of, well, if you count cars and buses as people. It looks like the middle four have traffic, and the outer two have pedestrians. But I know for a fact that there's another one inside under those archways that goes through to the left over there, a separate passageway. So, I don't know. I don't know, though, for a fact. I'm actually wondering now if I dreamed it. You can see how the sun is sinking rapidly. It's just now reaching through the trees. I picked this spot here for my last shots because I realized that the sun, even obscured by clouds, will come through here and give me a vision of light. Take a picture. Ooh, we're in the courtyard of the Louvre Palace. Look at that. Take a picture. Take a picture. Take a picture. Uh-oh, we're going away now. Bye. There, see the open archways over there? That's where the road goes through. After it goes around the big circle, back, goes through. Oh my god, I'm running out of battery power. This is gonna be it. Coming to the end. Yes. Oh, will they make it? must admit, I do not know where that light in those windows is coming from, except that it is reflected. Perhaps off the pyramid. But the pyramid doesn't seem to be lit up. The angle. A reflection would be to the left and slightly up. So that means it's reflecting off the wing of the palace over there. It's probably still lit up. It appears now that the light is fading. Even as my battery is dead.